favor. Away!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Critcast for you tonight. We have UGC Season 24 Highlander action, European Platinum Division between... I'm just gonna call them Kitties because I cannot pronounce their real name, and the Doctors of Mediocrity. I am Stinson out for you, and with me is Premiership Spy and Meme Main, Domedo. Domedo, what can we expect from this game tonight?
Good evening. We can only expect as much as the actual map that we're playing on gives us and the actual league we're playing on, because this is week 2, because we actually like didn't have enough casters to cover week 1, but we are live now in UGC, so we are on UGC on Lakeside, so we have an interesting league and probably the worst map in the map pool, with the only pool room in the map pool, and therefore I don't know what we can expect, but we might be kind of a bit biased, maybe, since a little bit, because it is actually Dr. Med against Kitty's Bacon Bardami, I think. I actually hope it's pronounced like that.
Probably not.
It will probably be. But I'm feeling good. Like, I think we can actually see... I mean, we will see at least 4 rounds, Stinson, so I don't know, you can... I just give you the doubt to take the prediction, to take the first team.
I think shootings we can be sure we're gonna have tonight is a lot of punts, because Domedo is here, and a lot of headshots, because Lakeside is one of the sniper-friendliest maps in Highlander I can think of, and thus is very much hated by me as a medic main. You just get headshot, you get jumped, you get backstabbed, you get all kind of things, so... usually I just go rage crits and then things happen.
Rage crits?
Rage crits, yes. Rage
I know
crits
that.
Is
That's
best
amazing.
Crits. Yeah. Would you do us the honors and go over the Kitty roster, Domedo?
Kitties, yeah, in a second. They actually don't have all their players as we're just waiting for them, but we do have the insights on the rosters. And therefore, let's see, we have the big, I imagine he's big, at least in game or maybe in real life, I don't know, it's Lightclaw on the scout class. It is Vress on the soldier class, making up a Russian flank that basically do M1s into every enemy, because this is what Russians do. Then Paradox on this Pyro class, so that's an amazing name, because I don't even know why this Paradox class is still in the game to begin with. Crime, probably the only cast who will ever laugh at my jokes, since I appreciate that. Crime on the Demo Man. GD, Jesus Christ, GDG, GDJ on the Engineer, I guess, yeah. Only engineers have that. What are these names? Meth, like not the drug, but like meth on the medic class. Nakari, on something else. I think Nakari might actually be on engineer. They actually didn't sort this by class, I just realized. I think Aine is on sniper though, and yeah, Imba. I remember Imba. Russian spy has been around for ages, you know, like, I don't know any of these players, but I always know the spy, so Imba will be on the spy class, for instance, so, I don't know, maybe these names actually ring some bells, but you do know, like, you don't even have to, you're not allowed to open score, but you just have to give me a roster rundown of Dr. Med right now, without, like, looking at the players.
Oh, you know, I haven't played with them in a long time. You know, for everybody who's lost by now, Domedo and I used to play for Dr. Mediocrity for almost, I guess, 2 years. So, we know a lot of these guys very well, but obviously they did have changes since... At least I left them in 2016. I'm gonna try to make sense of what I see here on the server, because I don't actually have confirmed them. I think it's gonna be Asirson on Scout, Prophet on Soldier, Super Freddy on Pyro, Lion King on Demo, Senash on Heavy, Dizzy on Engineer, we have Beckler on Medic, Killer Hulu, who is actually a Finnish import, Killer Hulu, I'm just gonna call him Kyla on Sniper, and Flowey on Spy. So most of these players have played together for a longer amount of time, but they did make some adjustments. They moved Prophet back and forth. I think Senash was medic before, now he's playing heavy, but yeah, I mean, definitely we know these players much more than the Russians on the other side, but both teams, I'm pretty sure, have been around for a long time. Kitty has been around at least for 4, 5, 6 seasons, so it's in no way a new team. But yeah, Dux and Medicity should show some synergy, although I remember we didn't like to play Lakeside back then, Tomato, did we?
No, we didn't. Well, what we did, we basically, I don't know, like, get carried by a pick class all the time in the day. No, but really, you know, on this map in particular, like, not even pick classes, but the flank is just so brutal, and just shout out to Prophet, like, oh, the flank for Dr. Matt is, or the flank for any team, really. So you just see the showdown, probably, because when it revolves around pool room. So they basically have to play conservatively against a Russian flank that will just go forward basically all the time. So yeah, I don't know. The thing with Lakeside is it can get a bit messy at times, but the main issue is just teams are maybe not exactly realizing at times what the actual win conditions are on this map. I mean, of course it's the midpoint, I just mean where you can play from, because you have a lot of routes to play from, but like maybe you can say something about the strategies, because like I don't actually want this, because I feel like I'm betraying product, because it's a way better map in every aspect of this, and I really don't like Lakeside at all.
But, yeah,
I mean you made medic, you're on as well. So
I'm on your side here, because I always thought that Lakeside is weird in the sense of it's a huge map, and whoever holds the point has such a big advantage, because he also has the high ground advantage. But then if you stand on point while you have it, then you get sniped. If you stand behind the point, you get bumped. I never really got the hang of it, and I'm really glad we swapped it out in ETF to Earth for the most part, because I mean, why made it fun for flank classes, because you can jump and you can have a lot of DM fights, 1v1s, 2v2 skirmishes. I think organized play on this map is really hard.
You heard it here first, swapping out maps because admin doesn't like playing it. It's good. It's good stuff.
Nah, I made my case, and since we only have 5 weeks, ETFTL, one cost
just
map had to go.
Yeah.
And like I said, product is the far superior map. It's also much younger, so I would never dream of abusing my admin powers there just because I don't like a map. Wink, wink. But yeah, who do you think is gonna be the main man to watch on either side here?
The main man.
Or woman.
Oof, yeah, that's alright, because Doctors of Mediocrity actually have the quota of women, so I think if the Russians win, that's offensive or something. I think that's the thing today.
Yeah, it's probably harassment. Like,
yeah, probably. Just
me
get
too.
It's banned. Well, even though you probably can't get these banned, because GC, it's an interesting league. But in essence, you know, it's just pick classes. I always just say pick classes are carrying, but then again, this is what happened for seasons. I always give a bit too much, I don't know, like, shit, I would say, to the combo, because it's like not actually fair, but it's really hard sometimes for a combo to be coordinated or to do something if your name is like not actually Joe and you scream at your entire team to walk forward. So it can be difficult at times, but I just think, again, flank classes and the pick classes. But you know, since you asked me for the exact players, I think the first 2 rounds max will decide what will actually like which player will prevail in their respective sides, you know, like on the pick classes, on the flank classes.
Yeah, flank classes. I mean, traditionally the Russian teams in 6th or Highlander that I played against are really strong in their DM. So I would give the flank advantage over to Kitties, because I'm fairly certain that Prophet and Sonny, or CSN rather, are not the MGE lords that the Russian duo might be. I think the carry for the Doctors of Mediocrity should be Lion King. He has been outstanding since he made the transition from engineer to demoman.
Even before that,
Yeah, even as an engineer, I think he topped damage at some point as an engineer on Lakeside, actually. So, yeah, if he can find the damage and his team can clean the frags up, then that will definitely be a plus.
You could argue that this was because 8 of our players were dead constantly on this map, but yeah, I had and only mini sentry survived. But you do have a point. Actually, these teams are taking so long. I don't think they're actually this hungry for blood. It's cringe. No. In general, yeah, you said Lion. Also, because I actually handpicked him with Selic back in the day, I just also go for Flow. You probably do a lot as well. Just shutting down the sniper is really important. And Aine's on the sniper. We know Aine very well. I think he will definitely be the player to watch, actually, if I look at this roster. I also know Nakari is really good, but I don't know how much Gaudim.
Judging by what I see when I press tab, Aine might also have the only name I'll ever pronounce tonight on the blue side here. Because we have Imbiyasha, and we have someone who actually used Kyrillic, and WRZ and LC50. I'm just going to call out their classes and their blue colors, and then I think everybody has to live with that. Because I haven't had Russian. Although I live in a, you know, formerly Russian zone of Germany, I've never had Russian in my entire life, so I'm not good with Russian names or anything like that. We do have 17 people on the server, I believe, 18 in real life, so we should go live momentarily here. Just waiting for Kitties to get the last players in, and then we should start this off really soon. And like you said, this is UGC rules, so we will play to first to four, best of 7 rounds, and after, I think, first to 3 rounds, we will have a little bit of a break for teams to get sorted, maybe get a drink and go to the toilet. So we're going to have 2 halves, so to say. We'll be here for a little while.
At least for 4 rounds. At this point, if I would be playing in this, I would just say it's time for default win, because it's actually like 20 minutes past. You could claim default win in this raid, but these teams, they don't know. They want to actually show what they can do, which is actually not doing that much. Like, they're not even like fighting properly in pregame. What is this? Oh, there's, okay, Kalalu, close range. I actually shouldn't bring casting the pregame. No, that shouldn't be a thing. Yeah, but I don't know. Oh, we're going live since, and you see, we bought them enough, now they're actually going, and
exciting stuff, everybody. This is UGC Highlander Season 24 Platinum Week 2. In the blue, we have Kitties, and in the red, we have Dr. Medicity. Our first mid on Cod Lakeside is live, and we have the Russian Demo Man. Be really strong on the point, he has a strong presence, but he does take a lot of damage, so he has to back off. Sunny is trying to pressure him. Now the pool fight arrives, and first blood for the Dogs of Medicity here in the pool room. That should bring the pressure up to the boiling point. Lion King gets another frag onto the Demo Man. Nice snipe from Killer Hulu on Uro, and this should be a Doctor's Miraculous mid commander.
Yeah, definitely. They just focused Purum, and then they took the fight to them on the left side, seen from the Russian. I mean, the Russian demo just, I don't know, like rushed forward on the Smith, but he actually took a bit of damage. He was way faster than Lion King, but he couldn't quite convert it. As the, what was that? The scout got bedded down, or he bled to death. Oh no. What is this? Don't know how unlocks work, but currently Doctors of Mediocrity have settled very correctly in this on this point and are actually looking quite well, as the Russian combo is moving into the pool room, as they have a full Uber to play with, but also Dr. Matt just having a full Uber and just waiting for the Russians currently to make a move, as Aine actually went down. That's a big pick. Senaj is really close, they pop the Uber and they just kill the classes here. Oh no, they only have a Pyro to Uber on the Russian side. This, I don't know, Dr. Matt just realized the advantage, and Kitty just not on the same wavelength there, still.
Yeah, I mean, this was the awkward thing where Dr. Matt opted to hold behind the point, and then the Kitties just took the pool room, which is smart because they have the high ground advantage there. But they lost 2 or 3 players, and their Uber exchange actually was a disaster. But now they do get some picks here. Lion King goes down to a nice snipe from Aine, and there's the position on point, and Dr. Mediocrity is smartly back out because they don't want to lose their medic whatsoever, and they're gonna back up all the way to spawn.
And just all the way out. Oh my. Aine also just getting a headshot on Kala in the end there, and Freddy getting fragged by a soldier there. So just regrouping currently. The Ubers are still equal, but now it's really to see to kill Aine. He's just sitting there, and Beckler actually got a saw onto him. I don't know if he got Uber off that. He might have gotten, but didn't actually matter because he was close to Uber anyway. Nothing really happening frag-wise currently, as the Dr. Medcom was just trying something on Purim right now, as the Russians have settled there and Lion gets piped down by Crime and Sunny goes down to Aina. So maybe Dr. Med will probably start to bleed now as the Pyro is on the Prophet. Prophet does escape though, Stinson. He is completely fine, but it just goes down in the as the Blue Soldier conscious in the time stakes for Kitty.
Yeah, the conscious is not gonna do a hell of a lot here. Nobody's around to shoot, but yeah, I'm looking at Flowey here because I think it's up to him to get the pigs in the pool room. But obviously, since everybody's in there, it's really cramped now. Here goes the Doctors and Doctor G, though, trying to measure the point. The blue Uber and the red Uber gets popped here. A lot of flashing going on both ways. But no frags really here for the Doctors and Mercury. They lose Lion King, the big damage dealer. Now the Conch comes in, but nobody's really there to shoot anybody. And the pool room is untouched here. Four people down for the Doctors and Mercury, and a nice snipe from Aina on Flowey. Holy moly, Aina is on a roll so far.
Hacker. Just the Russians were just a bit too passive. Like, so weak people on Dr. Met, they're actually cleaning them up. Now they're on the long respawn. They have absolutely no business of holding this. They need to back out here. This is really important. There's an engineer on the medic. Ooh, it's so close. Beckler is so weak. And this despite there as well. Just guns down Beckler. Oh no, the heavy stall, the frag. That's what I don't know, combo classes do, they just feed off the frags, you know. But in essence, I don't know, Dr. Matt just had the health disadvantage, so they just didn't back out like strong and fast enough. So now a complete Uber advantage for the Russians, as they also go into the lead time wise, and just having Ayn in this pool room and the combo on top left, so it's really hard to do something. As Kyla gets a frag though, actually gets Imba gunned down as well by Senash, so there are some openings, but they really have to break this as soon as possible right now.
And down goes the soldiers. Well, nice find here by Lion King, and they're gonna pressure the point here. They don't have to Uber, but they kind of want to force the Russians onto the point and use into them, kind of baiting. There you go. Now it's time for Beckler to run out here, because they're gonna come after him. No soldier to jump in though, and Crime is doing his best, but Senna just takes so much damage. Prophet is behind on the point, gets the frag on the heavy, now jumps out, but he's gonna get cleaned up. But yeah, this was good exchange nonetheless. They baited the Russians onto the point, made them pop over. Now they have 90%, they're moving in here any second now. Ayn has a nice position on top of the balcony though, and a nice sideline on the medic. This is so dangerous to Mato, they should pop it early. Killer Helo goes down to a pipe, no sniping contest there, and they just get the point for free.
I don't think they actually will. They have pull for now, but they need to watch out because they're probably getting forced in. It's only Lion Ford. Lion needs to pull a lot here. We know that he's capable of doing that, but it was kind of bad there because the coordination was really off. The flank classes of Dr. Matt went in before, like you could see Flowey going in on the combo and not. I don't know, the coordination was just off with the flank classes, and that's usually what happens now. They just use the Uber aggressive on them. They don't even have to get these frags, they just have to scare them away. And just, oh, Beckler gets stepped as well. Like, this is so important, you know. You just have to scare them away and don't even get this many frags in the Uber itself. Just clean up afterwards and cap the point, because now it's only 10 seconds, and Dr. Matt actually don't have any players forward. It's gonna be really difficult. Kyla goes down. This will definitely be the sunset for this round. And I just want to point out, it was Aina on a 10k during the match, so they need to shut off the sniper. It's only Pyro currently on the points. It's piped down looking at the damages, straight up demolished, but yeah. Since the first round, after actually looking really good for Dr. Matt, goes into the favor of the Russians.
Yeah, Kitty won up here, and after the first round, no time to complain though. Into the second mid we go. Crime is fast again. Lion King is trying to find the damage here. Crime is on half health, actually third health. If someone would just jump in and kill the Demo Man already, but nobody does. So first blood for Killer Helo on the nice snipe on the Pyro. So no
frags
is gonna come there. And now the scout is in position to take the pool room. No contest from the doctors, and there's actually three players behind for the Russians. They're gonna get sandwiched here.
I feel like the Russians are kind of slow. The heavy now walks forward but gets cleaned up. This is actually played well by Dr. Matt, because, I mean, there are players behind, but if these players are not quick enough, you can just clean them up afterwards. They have pool room currently, as Prophet also gets down. Also nice serve from Flowey there, from pool room. But currently they're actually trading for a point a bit, but the Matt went down that, I think he died to pick class, because that's what they do. And Dr. Matt has an Uber advantage, they just need to watch out for bombing soldiers. The kitties are actually controlling their room, but Sunny's on the demo! Oh, that was so weak since.
Yeah, but did you have to go there? That's my question. You don't have to, right? You have the point.
Just
you don't
forward.
Have to overextend. Yeah, you just don't have to pass the scout into people. Now you're just kind of bleeding here. As nothing's really happening. Yasha is behind, trying to distract as much as he can. The Russians still go into the map room again. No contest. And Yasha not gonna go on a play on the medic, but he gets taken out and actually find out. Now the red Uber is popped here in the blue room, and they're gonna clean up the frags in the middle. This is huge. This was direct, exactly the right decision. Just walk into them glowing, and they can't do crap about it.
Yeah, the NG is currently DMing a Pyro. Will he win the fight? No, Freddy, back away. 11 HP. He will get out. Oh, he's getting chased by the... No! Ooh, Nakari there with the Scout MGE. I think I know what play Scout. Gets cleaned up by Kyla in the end, but Dr. Matt are looking strong right now as Russia is taking their top right side currently. Russia, the Russian team, not the entirety of Russia. The medic is on 30 HP though, that's pretty... Ooh, he goes down there, nice spam from Prophet. You see, like, they were so vulnerable to the spam, but they actually get the frags. That's the main issue if you just start bleeding. And Russia need to go forward now with their past respawns and numbers because they actually can't wait for the medic, maybe?
Yeah, I think because we can't pronounce any name, we're just gonna call it Russia versus Germany here, and we're gonna make it a Highlander Nations Cup because this is way too messy. But yeah, the small adventures do go to the Russian team, so as we have a pause, I believe. Yes, we do. I was gonna say the small adventures do go to blue because they do not own the point, and if you do not have the point, in case you didn't know, you're gonna spawn a little bit faster than the opposition. But there's already 2 minutes off the clock here for the Doctor of Mediocrity, and we have a Russian player dropping. Obviously, this is 9 seconds. Obviously, this is 90 seconds in the future since we're in STV delay, so it's nothing that happens at this exact moment as we speak. But yeah.
I probably lost the round screaming at each other currently. The main issue currently is probably for us two that we have to retry after this pause, but you said Russia versus Germany. We don't have to imagine that in our heads. We actually had showdown in the Nations Cup and we saw who reigned superior in this kind of scenario.
Well, refresh my memory, what happened there? I didn't watch it.
You didn't follow Germany.
No.
Yeah, we won. Easy. That's what happened. Back on this match, you know, like, I can already feel how close this will be because, I mean, on my HUD it completely ticked down, but it was like 1 minute to go for Dr. Matt, so they're actually looking in pretty good shape. And as you pointed out, the spawn advantage is only as good as you can actually make it work. I mean, of course, people know you have to go full davai, as the Russians say, and even if you do that, you kind of sometimes get picked off, though I have to say, the Russians always have this pool control, like pool room control, but they're actually not making this much use out of it, to be quite fair. I mean, they have the pick class working for them, and the flank is actually, like, strong, but I feel like they're actually lacking on the combo fight a bit, Stinson.
Yeah, so far they didn't have to, because they had Iron is sniping everybody, and, you know, the soldier is jumping behind all the time, so the combo was just kinda sound and safe there in the pool room. In the first round it did work out, but now the Darks of Mediocrity did adapt. And I think they pushed into the pool room with the Uber advantage where they wiped the Russian team. Might just be enough to secure this round, but you know, it's just 1 minute to go versus 3 minutes. It's not over whatsoever. Lakeside can be really swingy to a point where even if you're behind and you get a recap, then you wipe them once, you wipe them again, you have the high ground. It's definitely possible to get back into the round here. It's not a map that, you know, is lost whatsoever at any point.
No, definitely not. The only thing that is lost currently is my mind as having to listen to this heavy as he's directly pointing at Sonny, and ooh, I wanted to say, does he survive that? He does survive that. He actually, like, really nice stuff there from the Red Scout, from the Dr. Matt Scout. As I have sliding players now, but currently Dr. Matt are just taking their side here close to the enemies, but the demo is getting good spam on them. As, ooh, he actually gets spammed. He's 5 HP, he's so weak. And they are following up on this as well. As sliding as Yerson for me killed the demo man with big pick, and also the heavy's really weak in pool room. You see, that's what we just pointed out. They're just lacking on the combo fight. They're a bit too off. They are like the demo committed, but the rest of the team was not really supporting him. His Aine just completely fires Freddy out of the sky. There's just sit down kid. And currently they're kind of slow here, Dr. Matt. Like, they killed the demo, but they're just... Like, the power of Shoe Room is showing currently, and the demo is just sticking off behind point, Stinson.
Yeah, I mean, they do have a lot of time, and actually the time ticks down here. It's only 15 seconds left for the blue team to cap the point. And the Doctors kind of chill out behind the point. They don't have to do anything. They just wait for players to overextend into them, as now the contest comes and the blue Uber is being popped, completely catching me off guard because my Uber count is not fixed yet. And there's a lot of blue frags going this way. Now the red Uber is popped, but I'm not sure if it's gonna be enough, but they do get the frags. Nice cleanup by Sony, who gets a 3k there. The scout from Dr. Macrity just capitalizing on everybody's damage, and this should be the round. So the Doctors do tie it up, 1-1.
With the spy class top fraying, like top pointing, big surprise. Also, demo with the highest Lion King, with the highest kill streak there. Like the clay, as we actually pointed out, as we are on the next mid fight, the demo is like faster again. He's actually sticking off. I think Sonny took a bit of damage there. Sonny's really weak. That SCR stun, for anyone who is not aware of this, is Sonny. Currently, Dr. Matt, they take opposite routes here. Soldiers in, the scout actually goes down, so that's an opening. As the heavy is getting spammed here, but the demo actually takes down Lion King before, so there, oh, the spies in as well, like so many frags, they are just exchanging all over the point. It's 3v4 currently, and I think it's favoring Dr. Matt more than anything, as both medics actually stayed alive, and the medic on the Russian side has only a pyro to heal, but Freddy wisely backs away from a hacking sniper to the safety of the point as Dr. Matt go down with the first mid fight.
And Beckler actually with a 2k here, the Dr. Symbiocrity medic getting two frags with his crossbow, and this might just be the reason why they won this mid fight, because initially it didn't look well for the Germans, but now like you said, both medics did survive, so the Uber's situation is equal, as Aina gets a frag on Killer, so no snipers for the Doctors, and Aina can now kind of range shots down, which he does, gets profit as well. Aina, he's on a streak today.
Yeah, definitely, he's like on an extra blast. Ooh, Sinash, this was so close. What is this flashing by the Russian combo? They just literally, the heavy was in the face of the other heavy, and except like saying, okay, you take this Uber, but I guess it doesn't matter anyway, because Demo actually gets fragged as he gets headshot by Kyla there, but I don't know, like, kinda unfortunate splitting up there by the Russian combo, and currently this is still on the point, and she's defending that like a champion. It's 1 minute in the favor of Dr. Matt, but the blue medic stayed alive since, and so the 40% advantage for the Russians right now.
First cap for the Russians since the first round, actually, and now, yeah, Dr. Simic, you have 1 minute advantage, but they're gonna get out here. The soldier gets cleaned up, WRZ, and we have a scout on the battlements, but he's 1v2. He actually kills the Searson and heals off of the demo and gets the frag with the pyro help. But meanwhile, on the point, we just have the Germans kind of walking forward. It's what you do when you're behind. You just walk forward, you're gonna bait them on the point, and now they're gonna rain the damage in there, like Super Freddy just bossing everybody, Senna just cleaning up the frags. And again, Russia's just kind of holding in that map room without Uber, and they get punished for it.
It's so easy for them, like they kill the sniper there, okay, because they don't have the long range denial from the Russians, and then they just walk into Purum, and Russians still think that they will approach from this one side, but they don't, they just walk through the point and then they just crush them with coordinated spam. It's really good to see the combo fights actually being important, but see, like, Dr. Matt, they just let them take the Purum because in the past it's like worked out for Dr. Matt in the end, and currently they're not actually getting any captain because they have to walk into a huge wall of spam. Currently though, Crime went down to Sonny, like good trade there, scout for Demo Man, really important as the pyro goes down there for the Russians, and just so many frags again just from this map room. They're actually useful, but you know, they're just getting sandwiched all the time in this kind of area. They probably need to have a different approach to this.
Man, I wish we were casting Bad Warder, then we would both be right with map room, and of course it's Purim. But yeah, we see it all over again. The Russians just be in the map with the Germans pushing and killing them. This has happened multiple times now, and I'm curious if they're gonna adapt at some point, as Crime just kind of feeds in. The Demo Man is dead for the Russians, and everything is
in the water.
Suicide round now,
fire
shot! Nobody's actually gets better. What the heck?
The pyro class, why is this thing still in the game? He just went into the pool, into the only water on the entire map pool. He just went into the water and got frags as a pyro, and they're going to cap the point off of that, so... Or maybe not, as the demo's the only one on the point and gets stabbed by a spy there, but maybe, no, they're actually delaying this, you know, like they're so slow all the time. I feel like Russians are a bit slow, but they're taking the point right now, and it's equal Ubers. They're actually still on normal melee gun. As we have to see, again, Dr. Matt is approaching from the lower left of the Russian side viewpoint. Weird language as they're approaching left side Stinson. Let's see.
Yeah, killer falls to Ayn, a nice snipe, and they do take a lot of damage, the doctors are. And, you know, there's gonna be the tease on the point, but Sonny gets taken out easily, and there you go, there comes Crime and Uro, the combo for the Russians, and kind of just post up on the point together with the conch. So hitting themselves and being faster, Beckle actually has to be really careful to not fall here, as he kind of dodges spam like a boss, but he's getting chased, and now he's safe, so there was another... You know, try for a dry push here from the doctors, but that failed miserably this time around.
And to be quite fair, I mean, it's a kind of a bait you have to take. I would say it was actually a good thing to do because Beckler stayed alive. I don't know, like, how much they actually to have him alive there, but it could have been way worse. Like, you can always try this as long as your medic doesn't commit too much to it, because now they have a Uber fight again for Purum. We'll see how this works out if the Russians actually, like, step up their combo fight. Currently, they're taking a lot of damage, and way better Uber there. Like, really good Uber management by Dr. Matches. Having a single Uber on the heavy, because they forced the Russians to that, and they actually force us to retry after this again, as we have the second pause in... Like, this is, what is this pause? And I think that... I thought this meme was dead, but, you know, like, 30 minutes before the game starts, 2 billion pauses in the game. What is this, Stinson?
Yeah, I think someone on the Russian side has serious issues with the internet connections, you know. Russia versus Germany is always a battle, for stereotypes as well, and I guess the Russian internet connection today from East Siberia is kind of causing troubles here. But the Russians did make a comeback. I mean, it's only 1 minute left for them, I think, before we paused, and it's only 50 seconds difference. The Red Uber was better, like you said, they have the better Uber, but look at that heavy in pool room. There's nobody left to shoot. Yeah, they're completely alone, so the last ticking moments of this Uber won't be very effective. And then you have the demo just staring at them. Beckler will have a hard time surviving. And we have a heavy guarding the point. I'm not sure if they can actually get on and cap the point after this is done here in the pool room.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. Like, it depends. Both pick classes on both teams, except Flo, but both snipers are still alive, so maybe they can make something happen. I have to say, I didn't actually... Because this map is a bit messy for me, I actually didn't have a look how... Well, Kyla is playing with this combo, but he's on the top right currently. I don't know if the Russian combo maybe commits to the point, he might get a bigger impact, but currently, as the kitties are positioned, they should take this. As we actually go live again, and no, okay, it's just a derping pyro into Purum. But Beckler actually goes down to Aina there. I thought he would die to the stickies, but as you said, he was very vulnerable in this position. Imma also gets taken down, but just the frags coming in for the Russians right now, only 3 up on the side of Dr. Matt, so only one last chance to actually push this. This is alone on the point. Will she get a 9k now? No, she doesn't, but obvious bait, obviously, just for the sniper. Kyla to take down the blue soldier there, as, yeah, just one last really to go through.
Yeah, one last push, indeed, and Flowey is trying to get behind the sniper now. Actually, Ayn is so low, but he gets defended by his own spy, you know? If you can't defend against the spy, you get your spy in, and then everybody will go out. So Dr. Mekuchi, again, kind of made the point so much cap time already. They can't let this go, the Russians. But they do, and now it's only 10 seconds. This is gonna be a photo finish here, Tomato.
They have Uber though, you have to be like, they have 30%. Oh, what did they have? The medic! Ouch! Oh no, this was probably the saving drop there. Just Lion just killing, but only 4 up or 3 up for Dr. Matt. Oh no, this was so clutch. They have 10 seconds, but I don't think the response will get into this. This was so well played. I don't know, like, Beckler went down there as well, probably, because this was the crucial 10 seconds. They got the med drop. They just bled all of the players after that, kind of. Oh no, so just kitties getting here because, you know, spawns are not quick enough, and 2-1 for kitties, as It was so equal, like Dr. Matt could have taken that just so even these teams right now in the third and fourth mid fight actually.
Yeah, actually kind of weird. I mean, they do drop the medic, but they still lose every player. And here we go into the fourth mid, 2-1 up for the Kitties, and the season is really aggressive on the point again. Gets taken out by Aina, and now the mid fight really unbased. Yes, and this has nothing to do with the sentry gun. Lion King just trying to get what he can. Nobody really committing to anything yet, no bombs, as Flo is molesting Aina in the background. Trying to get the sniper back, and he does, so no sniper here for the Russians. Heavies don't really want to commit to the point. Frey's just, you know, he has had enough, he's just going in, bragging heavy, so no machine gun dude.
The spice on the med as well, so that was actually good coordination. Like 100 damage from the revolver onto the medic, and then Kyla just killed them. Now they can just clean up. Come on, Prophet, go for the airshot though, but they can crush them here if they're a bit quick. Prophet though goes down, and they're kind of bleeding here because this is forward, not because this is forward, my train of thought is fading, but because they kind of were not on the same wavelength. Senaj there though, making lemonade out of lemons and actually killing the demo there, actually delays this, but the spy will just clean him up because this is what Heavy does, staying in the middle, just having to fight the entire team. But only 24 seconds in the favor of Dr. Matt. They do have advantage though, as the sniper and the scout go down, so it's kind of hard to push without the scout on this map because you have so much ground to cover and you have to chase them, and Russians are still committed to this pool room.
Yeah, they are committed, but Aina is down and their soldier is down, so no spam and no headshots. As the red Uber comes here, it's being soloed on Lion King once again. He does get the demo man, but he does not get the medic just yet. Actually, he goes down. Nice work from Flowey, but Becklev has to commit too much and gets flamed by the pirate. Now the respawns come in for the Russians, and there's no hits for either side.
That was not Backlaw's fault. These were these new overpowered flames. He actually went into the only water there is like ever played on a comp map, and he still died to a pyro. In the end, it was again just Dr. Matt kind of edging out there a bit. I mean, they lost Dekla, but they got the frags. And as I wanted to say, like, if Sonny was alive at that point, they would have crushed them so much because, I mean, Lion did hit his pipes, but they just didn't have enough chance. Like, they could have done way more in the Super, like, they could have crushed them. Oh no, Kyla!
I just watched the Nightclaw, the scout from the Russians, beat Kyla with his back to death. He had no idea he was just coming from behind. That was hilarious, I'm sorry.
It's fine. I mean, as you just said, that literally everyone died there from Dr. Matt. I mean, this was definitely because the sniper killed... the scout killed the sniper with a... But, yes, because the Russians, you see what they do, like, this time they realized, okay, they are not on this one entrance, so we just push out there and then we crush them if they want to commit to the point and go from the other side. So now they're actually playing this well and they have like 80% advantage, kind of hard for Dr. Matt. I mean, they still have 30 seconds in their favor, but they really need to pull a lot here. I feel like the combo fight is like equal, but I feel like the flank might need to step up. Like Sonny is dying again, since you see that, like, that's kind of lacking for them currently. I have the impression.
Yeah, when the combo is committed to this pool room here, it probably goes down. But Dr. Matt continues to the spam, and this is easy spam. Your Lion King is super low. They do try to force the blue medic off, but he's just hiding in the corner and waiting. He doesn't take any damage, so someone has to walk around. You can't just stay in one corner and expect the medic to pop the Uber. As Aina goes down, you're blowing with a nice stab. Using distraction on the front of the pool room to get the stab on the sniper. So they do have 4 picks, but they can't really move forward as now the Ubers are getting popped in the middle.
Yeah, it's still kind of equal. Like, super, Freddy can deny this as he's hiding in the water again. What are these pyros hiding in water all the time? Your flames don't work there, and you're not a pyro shark. So currently, Dr. Matt is getting aggressive on them though, as they don't actually clean. Okay, they get the combo down, that's good. I also have to say, Aina is just on this position that Flo is on him again. Flo is literally the only one, like, he's killing Aina so often, it's so crucial, but I feel like they're kind of lacking also, because, also, second step, Flo is on a 4k right now, he's just doing so much for Dr. Mad as they can contest this here. They have the numbers to do it, just need to kill this heavy, but they're just bleeding players against the Nash goes down, so that's probably mid-fight 1-4. Oh no, the Pyro class exists in the game! No, the medic gets flamed to death, but it's still a cap for the Russians, Stinson, but they lost their medic.
You know, there's a time in life where you just press W and M1 and it works, and now Backlow actually is in trouble, but he gets defended by Prophet. He's so low though, and Lightclaw is on the chase. He's gonna get the Lion King, and Crime is still on Backlow here. He does not find him. Backlow with the Jukes.
Yeah, well, the Jukes indeed, the Jukes. Currently though, the Dr. Mad actually have 80% advantage, so they can make this work. Not if they lose the heavy maybe to a sniper, but like the and their scout to a sniper. Like, as I was saying, Flo is doing really well on Aina, but they kinda also need to have their flank on them, as Flo is literally got out DM'd by an engineer who is taunting, get this kid banned from the server right now. As the demo man jumps in, Lion is chasing, but he like gets killed there, you know? That's what I mean, they're kind of lacking this this chasing potential there, and also Aina is just able to do whatever he wants if Flowey was not there. Like, they don't have this forward pressure, Dr. Mad, they're not looking forward the point. And maybe the Pyros though, I mean, yeah, the Pyro, but, you know.
Yeah, Slimmerfrey just seems to walk into the combo and kill someone. This is a good trade as a Pyro anyway. This is... it feels like it's too easy, but now the focus fire comes in from Dr. Mercury. Heavy, Blue Heavy gets down instantly, nice snipe. Finally, from Killer onto Aina, and there's 6 players down for the Russians, and we have only 15 seconds to go for either team. This is gonna be another close randometer, and here goes the Russians, 100% Uber. Backlow's on 80, so I'm not really sure if they can defend this.
Yeah, they're probably Uber here, but Freddy's actually... I don't think Tsenash needed to be this spot. I mean, he forced the Uber, this actually good, and he forced them to flash, so now they can... they need to Backlow survive here, as the Pyro is still there. Why is this Pyro the game? Oh no, Backlow is getting chased like 95% and he goes down.
Why
to
did
the
he run
scout.
Away from Prophet? He had a soldier on the point and decided to leave him on 97%. Oh my god, this is disastrous. This round is over and this half is going to be concluded momentarily.
Maybe.
There you go. It's
maybe.
3-1 for Kitty. Barara Kadinami against Dr. Zer Mediocrity.
We just call him Kitty Bacardi, I think that works for us.
Kitty Bacardi, that sounds tropical, dude. I like that.
To be quite fair, I wouldn't say they play like they're drunk, maybe in the combo fight a bit, but they actually have again Dr. Mitz just the second kind of round they lose to a cringed combo fight there a bit. Like, they needed to have Backlow alive, but he just kind of died, unfortunately, in the end. Like, it's so equal. To be quite fair, though, at this point, I would say, okay, this is how you do it. You know how you make a win even more crushing to the enemy team? You just give them hope, and then you crush them. Because now Dr. Mad just need to take the 3 rounds as a comeback. And
yeah,
then it hurts the Russians even more. You know?
Should be easy enough. And as I look on the logs
for
the first
right.
half, logs are always fun, right?
Useless numbers.
We have actually Lightclaw top fragging the scout for the Russians. 41 frags, Aina 34, Crime, which is a demo man, 25. And then we have our first Doctors and Mediocrity player from Flowey, who had 24 frags. So definitely getting out fragged here is Doctors and Mediocrity. And, you know, their scout, 41 kills, having such a performance, you're always gonna have your flank under pressure, you're always gonna have him behind, causing distraction and maybe even frustration for the sniper, because he's gonna have a scout on his butt. And that might also explain why Aina has just free range over Kyla and also actually doubles his kills in the first half, Tomato.
Yeah, like that's a post-factual comment if I say Lux are terrible, because Lux are sometimes not terrible if they show what I kind of pointed out during the game and you as well, because you just have to look. Flowey, 11 frags on the sniper, he was literally the only one killing Kyla, like, literally, only, Aina, only Kyla killed the sniper like 2 times and that was it. And actually surprised that Asirson got so many frags there quantitatively, even though he like got half the frags as we actually go into our 5th mid fight again. But yeah, kind of the locks there just sitting in, like, you can see, we can talk after this mid fight over them, but It's just the players that we pointed out, as nobody is doing anything, yeah, I guess. What is this?
I'm not sure if the Russians heard that it's going live. And
then a different time zone, you can judge them.
I'm not sure what's happening because Dr. Smith, could you actually go back from the point? Maybe they're gonna have a redo? If the Russians weren't there, and then now they just wiped Dr. Smith. This can't be right.
If this is actually right, then this is just a new invention of the pause strat we do as we are not ready, and then we actually go forward and kill everyone. What is this? This was a very interesting passage of play, but they're actually not rerunning like they're playing this, so big deficit actually. Yes, Beklau, it goes down again. I mean, Freddy gets a reflect on the Pyro showing who the superior Pyro is, but if this actually gets played now, I feel like this is kind of a throwaway because this is the last round to live really for Dr. Matt, and they're looking a bit bad here. I mean, the Matt also survived for the Russians and Beklau's on crits now, so that's actually a proper round, but kind of weird start there, Simpson.
No, I'm still waiting for the restart. I was so sure that was gonna have be a restart. The Russians were late and Doctors didn't fight back, but whatever, I guess we're just going with it. As Simpson is trying to edge the point out here, and the Russians do stick to the let's stay in the pool room kind of strategy, and I like the decision to go crits from Beklau in case he survives, because the blue Uber is spot, but he is kind of safe. There is a Pyro on the chase, so it's definitely not over yet. The Pyro actually gets Lion King and frags Prophet in the spawn, but Beklau is safe and sound, and now we're gonna have a Demo Man sticking the spawn. Does get any frags though, as he's caught out, but yeah, I like the decision to go crits here. Planet does lob some sticks into the pool room and wipe them, but for that to work, you'd have to get out of your spawn, Tomato.
Yeah, I would make them pay now for this infamy. These whales with sideburns, as Beat gave me the translation. Lightclaw clops down this with is this the thing that does no damage? I think this was the first time that I actually see someone getting killed by this. As the demo jumps in, but the frags actually come in from pick classes. What a surprise onto the Russians. So Dr. Matt actually going forward. They had to use their crits though, and I don't think they got this much with it because Meth is still very much alive. And the spice on the medic, but he does survive, so now they have full Uber as the cap went down into Dr. Matt's favor. But yeah, whales with sideburns is what Kitty is a bacon badami means translated. So as we are now in the clear, Dr. Matt can win now since.
Yeah, whales with sideburns. Shout out to Eckstein. But now meow. We have the meow. Now we have the blue team. They're kind of sticking to the point to the pool room strategy once again, but they do have to get on the point, otherwise the timeout is gonna tick down in the mediocrity favor. Only the combo is on the point currently, which is enough to take out Prophet. But now Kyla gets punished by the spy, and now yeah, there you go. The Russians find their way onto the point. Aina gets stabbed in the end, but so many people down for the doctors, and Crit is not gonna do anything against invincible players.
Yeah, they had this time window, kind of like the Russians popped. I don't know what this was, disrespect or something, like they popped their Uber 40 seconds, 40% of the crits went down, so there was a time window to make something work, but Dr. Matt are really looking on the back foot here as Flowey gets gunned down by the backscatter by the scout there, but Meth goes down to a snipe there by a body shot, and Beklau gets another saw. He's like, he has like 5 frags or something in this game, so now they can make this work. Go forward as Dizzy gets now killed instead of the does no damage, gets killed by the does no damage. But again, the fourth pause. What is this?
I can confirm that this was actually Beklau's fifth frag of the game. So yeah, the medic's almost fragging more than his engineer.
I have to say though, it's always a saw on the spy, and if people are like, ooh, these spies are feeding saws, no. I can say that for myself, I have a strange part, medics dropped on my knife, and if you feed sauce, then it's quicker for the enemy medic to get these ubers, and it's quicker for you to get the drops. But
That's the prime strategy here, as the pause actually is resolved. I do not see a lot of Russians on the server right now that are alive, but I also don't see a lot of Germans who go to the point. Just now they're coming in and trying to cap the point off, because there's only 5 seconds. Left for the Russians.
Freddy literally, like, the soldier didn't see the Pyro and the Pyro didn't see the soldier, so just weird battle right now. But now Dr. Matt are actually taking the pool room, so let's see. I mean, they have slide at, they actually switch to the Uber gun again as Prophet just gets taken down. had taken off there by Aine. But currently, yeah, as I was saying, Dr. Med now almost have Uber, and the main problem here is that the Russians have 1 minute in their favor, but we have to be aware that they paused, so there might be a comeback. That's no spoiler, that's just like, you know, thinking currently as they can crush the Russians here. They still have a slight slim ad. They actually used the war, but I don't think they will get the med with that, as the Russian medic is... Oh, he's actually kind of close. Sinash is coming here close! He forced the war at least. That's something.
Yeah, that's something. Yeah, that's turning a bad situation to something positive. But Backline now is in huge trouble. I think he's the one timing out, actually. Yes, because he did not move, and indeed he timed out from the server just as he got fragged in the bull room. This is... heartbreaking if you're a Dr. Mediocrity fan, because now the medic, I think this is where the pause happened. Now the medic has to rejoin and is definitely gonna have a disadvantage as the blue cap goes down here with only 20 seconds to go for the Dr. Mediocrity to cap it.
Big frag on the heavy right there. Like, this opens up everything. If the actioning can be quick enough and don't lead all of their players while they get the cap time and don't force overtime, but they can't do this, so they will force overtime. So they just need to focus now at not actually all dying, because Beckler also died in that. Imba gets picked onto Lion King. I mean, they're just dying here. This is over since, and the dream is dead. That's so unfortunate right there. Like, this had the potential to like go all the rounds, like all 7 rounds of this very, very subpar map, but it kind of didn't, and now it's flowy with the medic against the world, but is not happening.
Okay, so this is commencing our game here. It's 4-1 in total for the Wales with Sideburns, which is the translation for the Russian team title, as VTube googled out. And they're gonna take this game and their first win this season. These were 2 winless games playing teams so far. So Dr. Mediocrity off to a rough start to this platinum season with 2 losses, and as everybody already is out of the server, I have a look at the logs for the second half here, Tomato, and I see that Kyla, Dr. Mediocrity sniper, top fragged actually in this last round with 13 frags.
That's really quite fair. I don't think, like, I think we should, I wanted to say something about the logs before, because this was 1 round, and Russians kinda ticked off 1 minute by saying, we are AFK or something. Oh, big surprise, we are not, and we won't re-round or something. This was just weird, like, you know, like, I think Dr. Matt would have actually taken that round if it wasn't for that, but, you know, you can't have everything, and they kinda lacked in the crucial moments, as we saw, like, 2 maps only lost because of this kinda last combo fight there. But as we said before, I just have to kill time, basically, because I need to pull off these last round locks on my mobile phone. But the round before as well, like, the scout just from the Russians didn't die. Sonny died too much, and Aine was kind of just going down to the spy. I mean, they were winning, Dr. Med were winning, and they had the big potential to be way more winning on the combo fight, but in the end it was a bit off there. But yeah, like, Stinson, give us cold numbers that don't mean anything. You're ETF2 admin, you don't have, like, emotions anymore, so talk me through these numbers. Oh, we actually have combined logs now. Combined logs.
Where are those logs?
Yeah, I don't have them, sorry, I finished this.
I know, I mean, the only numbers we really do have to care about is the 4 on the one side for Kitties and the 1 on the other side for the Dr. Mediocrity. I'm sure the teams will find time to analyze what happened and to learn off of it, but let's not lose our heads here in the logs.
Actually, I actually had a flashback. I thought Beep was back, that's why I thought combined logs.
No combined logs tonight. I think 4-1, we have seen 5 close rounds of TF2, of Highland action. No need to waste anybody's time. Let's wrap this up, Tomato. Do you have any announcements to make? Any shoutouts to have you had? Anything else you wanna let us know?
Sure. I want to say, everyone who wants to be a cool player in this community that wields around 10 Highlander players and 12 Sixers players in this current scenario, you should go to the big Copenhagen LAN that is happening in Denmark, because this will be a cool LAN with a big prize pool and stuff like that, and you can watch this covered as well on Critzcast here. So we have this coming up for you, which is very, very interesting and nice, which will be definitely something to look forward to. As we are cheekily still a bit looking for people to talk over this, because if you think, wow, I have two Germans now casting my Highlander games, I don't want to listen to that, then you can step up and like be a caster yourself sometimes, and I don't know, like have bad puns, but people actually don't judge you for it because you have the right to do so. Just these two announcements, and just shout out to Dr. Matt. It was a bit unfortunate there. I think they could have taken that, but it's just the usual Dr. Matt illness. Like, I'm not surprised by this. This is what happened the last kind of 5 years or something. It's, you know, always the potential is there, but sometimes it's just a bit obstinate. Anyway, it was really good pleasure there. I think our first cast together, I really did enjoy that. So yeah. Do you have any shoutouts yourself, my friend? It was amazing.
Yeah, shout out, thank you. Oh, I'm blushing right now. But yeah, shout out to Fopish, to our producer. I think it was his first game tonight. And
second
game, yeah. You know, there was a hiccup in the beginning, but I'm sure he did a marvelous job on the stream. I did not catch that because I was busy, but I'm hoping
otherwise,
to see
he would
him
never
around.
Stream again.
Yeah, hoping to see him around. He is actually mentored by the greatest of them all, VTooth, so I'm sure he did quite well. Shout out to VTooth to organize this car. Shout out to you, Tomato, to join me and the teams. You guys, whoever is still in the chat, should follow Critzcast on any social media. You can join the Discord server. You can follow them on Twitter for any new information on upcoming casts, because this is going to be a regular thing from now. We're going to try to get at least one cast going each week on Mondays. So if you think, you know, this was nice, but you want to see some more, you want to learn more about high-level competitive EU plat gaming,
then go to YouTube.
Go to YouTube. You should tune in to Critzcast every Monday from now on. You mark this in your calendar. But yeah, I hope listening to two German accents wasn't too obnoxious, and I hope you all have a nice evening, and see you next time. Goodbye.